Hi everyone, welcome to 5 Minutes Crypto, brought to you by BitGet. In our podcast, we'll hear from founders, builders, investors, and traders as we discuss all things crypto in just 5 minutes. Today, I have a very special guest, Ashley Wright. She's the creator of Crypto Strategy Academy, a 7-week crypto and blockchain coaching program. She's also the author of the Crypto Strategy Workbook for Youth, an interactive workbook that teaches youth about crypto, NFTs, and blockchain. And she's also the co-founder of Femtech, formerly Crypto Babes, a global community of women in tech and the Blacks on Blockchain, an initiative to increase the representation of Black community in crypto and Web3. Welcome, Ashley.
Hey, Debbie. Thanks so much for having me. I'm so pumped to be here.
Well, you have to be pumped, actually, because we've only got 5 minutes to talk about this really, really broad topic. But I think you're probably the best person to have explain what exactly is crypto.
Yes, so great question. And yeah, I like to keep it as simple as possible. So cryptocurrency is really just a digital currency that really just removes the middleman out of the equation, right? Which allows us to take away a lot of the limitations that we see and experience with traditional government issued currencies today. So really, I like to say cryptocurrency allows you to be your own bank, because now you get access to all the traditional financial services and don't have to worry about how much you can spend, send, or even receive on a day-to-day basis, because all of those limitations are gone and you really get to have and do whatever you wish with your own funds, which is really great.
And Ashley, I'm going to jump on one of the key words you mentioned there, middleman. So can you talk to me about the removal of the middleman, or, you know, decentralization? How does it work in cryptocurrency?
Yeah, so that's a really key term. So decentralization is really like the concept of removing, you know, that, or I should say those managing parties that really kind of control everything. And now changing it up where everybody can get access to all those services and really just increases accessibility. So when we think about decentralization and middlemen, when it comes to, you know, cryptocurrency and something like Bitcoin, it's once again, the concept of you being able to really manage and use your own funds the way that you want, right? So a lot of times, you know, we have bank accounts, they tell us how much we can spend per day, or, you know, when we want to send international transfers, it takes very long. But with crypto, you can simply have a digital wallet, have funds, enter someone's address, and send funds to them regardless of where they're at, because it's borderless, and they'll get those funds literally in like seconds. So that's really the power of decentralization with crypto.
Ashley, so we've had the banking system for centuries now, so, and they've built up that level of trust. How are we building trust in the crypto space?
I would like to say that when we think about trust and the banking, you know, financial institutions, you know, there's actually tons of people around the world that don't even have access to that, right? So we have people that don't even have access to having a bank account or traditional financial services. So for them and where they're located, there is no trust, right, when it comes to those type of systems. And so because of that, you know, when it comes to something like crypto, it's not trust that they're relying on. But now with crypto, it's become a necessity of something that they need, right? And that's what they're using today when it comes to buying goods and services, or being able to have access to different financial services that, you know, we're not able to get if you don't have access or have any financial structure based on where you're located. So it's a little bit of both, where, you know, some countries we actually don't have that trust and it doesn't exist. And at the same time, for those countries where they do have a level of trust, this is where we're already starting to see them create their own digital currency, so to make sure that they don't also get left behind.
Yeah, actually, it's a good point to pull up undocumented countries. And it was interesting to see back in September 21, when El Salvador became the first country to make Bitcoin legal tender. And so if there's, you know, greater adoption with countries using Bitcoin, is Bitcoin still worth investing in?
Yeah. So, you know, before you can answer that, I have to put the disclaimer, you know, this is not financial advice. Please do your own research. But I know for myself, I always believe, yes, Bitcoin is still worth investing in, right? And the reason I say that is simply once you start to understand the fact that Bitcoin is a store of value, that it also has a very limited supply. There's only ever going to be 21 million Bitcoin ever. And then on top of that, it continues to grow in the utility, right? Or the adoption by large organizations and companies that are now using it. And then on top of that as well, the knowledge of, you know, or the amount of people that are becoming more knowledgeable about it is also growing. So that really speaks to its value, regardless of like the volatility in the market. You know, Bitcoin's not going anywhere, and we continue to see go up and increase in value and utility year after year.
And so we've established not financial advice. Bitcoin is still worth investing in. And we've got a lot of hodlers out there holding Bitcoin. What else is there for us to do in crypto right now?
To be honest, I think that, you know, and this is something I always teach like the students in my academy, is that there's different ways to get involved, right? Yes, you can hold Bitcoin, but there's over 15,000 different cryptocurrencies, and there's different ways to earn within the crypto space. So whether you're investing, trading, or finding ways to earn crypto, there's a lot of opportunities. Really just depends on, you know, what your strategy is, what you're trying to get out of this space, and why you're really getting involved, even before going out and deciding to like diversify your portfolio.
Yeah, and on BitGet, we don't have 15,000 coins, but we do have 600 of them that are available. And so actually, that 5 minutes is up. How quickly did that go? But I wanna let everyone know where they can find out more or learn more about what you're doing, Ashley. Where's the best place for them to go?
Yeah, you can reach me on Twitter, also known as X, or LinkedIn.
Great. And we'll have all of the details in our episode notes. And for anyone else that wants to learn more about crypto, please visit us at BitGet Academy.